Hello and welcome back to another tutorial. I am back, super excited for 2021. I took a month off work, which is probably the longest holiday I've taken off in the last few years, but now I'm excited for a 2021 in the next few months. If any of my students are watching, I know you guys are going to crush it this year, especially over the next few months. It's going to be an awesome year for hopefully everyone. If anyone else is looking to master their skill set this year and finally take the helm and commercialize their work and learn everything that goes into creating commercials, especially to do with products and 3D and all that fun stuff, click the link below. I've got a free training which gives you a basic roadmap on why you need to master your skill set in order to monetize it, and basically a monetization blueprint for your 3D. The free training will be in the link below if anyone's interested. In this tutorial, we're going to be going over the Razer Kraken project, which is this headset. I've done a tutorial on the modeling of this exact headset or a variant of it at one point, but then this one we're going to go over the texturing and lighting, just the basics of how this was put together. And for everyone that's interested to see that, I'm surprised I haven't done a tutorial on this because this was made quite a while back, but it seems like I haven't done one, so today I'm doing one. But yeah, without any further delays, we'll get right into it. So this is the 3D file, this is Octane, and then I did the lighting inside of HDR Light Studio, so I might as well load this thing in the background. And as you can see, basic structure that I've done for still images in the past is still applied here. So got a plane as the background, which is the backdrop. Then we've got a light here. So let me just change these settings. Cool. Yeah, we've got the lights. We've got the plane as the backdrop. And here's our scene, our headphones. And then the headphones are lit with HDR Light Studio. So is this the right camera angle? Yes, it is. So the back, I've used a Octane tag to separate the backdrop and this, so our lighting of the backdrop is not going to affect our headphones at all. So if I turn this thing off, you see our background and our foreground is kind of separate. And yeah, everything is pretty, well, wouldn't say simple. Straightforward, let's say that. So the strap has extra detail because I went into the sculpting mode and sculpted like extra creases and stuff like that, just to give it more of that less uniform 3D look, and look like it's more of like a worn piece of headphones. So here you can see we've got some basic, just went into the sculpt tool and literally just drew like creases and stuff in there. And then with the added support of like a normal map and stuff like that, you'll start to get more of this detail in here. So here I've just gone and used like a polygon texture for a leather material. You just apply it. The same as on these cuffs here. I've gone into the, what's it called? The sculpting tool. You just add some creases, very basic stuff. Don't really need to know anything too hectic with that. And then that's how you get some extra detail in those sections here. And here you can see it's just basic materials, gold material. Everything is pretty straightforward. Nothing too complex that any different to other tutorials I've done in terms of making materials and stuff like that. I just think the lighting over here is pretty good. So we'll go into that. So this thing is still fetching our scene from our host, which is a little bit annoying. Now we've got this inside here. If you take a look at our lights, we've got a lot of gradient lights here. And the reason why I went for gradient lights is one of the things I teach in like my programs and stuff is I really like to have gradients in my renders, just because that adds contrast. So one thing to avoid having a flat looking render is to make sure you've always got like gradients and contrast and stuff. And it's not a hard rule. I've just found when I have that in certain types of renders, it does make it look more dynamic and a lot better as opposed to just having flat lighting. So here just a bunch of gradients. So if I go turn all of these things off, got a bunch of gradients, and here I've got a flat background, and that's because when exporting EXR images and EXR renders, if you don't have a flat background, it can make things look weird. So you need to make sure you have a solid background. Otherwise, if it's transparent, it's it can make things look weird if you're exporting HDRs for your renders. But that's just a little thing. So here, we've got gradient lights. Again, pretty much the same principles I've taught in every other lighting video, just kind of lighting the features that you think need to be lit. So big one is the logo, having two lights on the sides here. And a lot of this was just kind of playing around until I found which one fit the best. So here we need a light to kind of highlight the edges so that we're getting some shape in. Realistically, I would probably add a light under here and maybe some more light here so you get some more detail. But again, like there's no, I don't really follow a rule book here, especially in this render. It was just kind of playing around with a lot of things and seeing which ones worked. If you've got good materials, you've got a good model, and you've got a good lighting system, then doing the lighting stuff shouldn't be that hard, especially if you've got a lot of practice and you know all the structured content of what to do, and just all the basic fundamentals should be pretty simple. So we can go through them one by one. Which one's the best one to start with? So I always like to start in black so that all the lights are kind of adding on top of each other and supporting each other. So here, if we're starting on black, one light, this job is to highlight the edge of the product here. The second light's job is to give some more detail and filling in this section over here, over there, and over here. It's more of a filler light. This light is clearly meant to outline, one, the logo or the brand of the product, but it also starts to define some detail in terms of like the materials used here. So how reflective is this? Is it like a, is this part more of a metal? Is it more plastic? You can kind of get more of a feel of like the materials of the product that you might be buying. But then this thing also adds a nice detail here, kind of revealing like more of the gold. So this makes it feel like, how can I say, more premium, more like more gold, shiny, reflective, fancy, whatever you want to call it. This light here, I like to add another light over here just because here with just one light, it's a little bit dark. Not enough detail is on the product yet. You can't really see what's going over there. Here it's kind of dark, and again it depends on the kind of style you're going for, but here I just wanted more detail, so adding in another gradient light here adds in some more detail on the top. And then the final light just fills in this area here. Realistically, you could add a light that fills in more of this region as well, but I thought this is enough lights, and in a sense that's pretty much all that went into the lighting for the product. And yeah, that's essentially it. The modeling gone through in a tutorial in the past, got a three-step tutorial for that. The texturing and materials, I've done a lot of this in other products, so it's, I kind of don't want to repetitively go over that. It's just same stuff, different normal maps depending on the product. This one, I think, was just like a more plastic normal map, which was from Polygon. You adjust the size so that it matches the real-world thing. I've got this project file on Patreon already if anyone really wants to really go into the nitty-gritty details of like exactly how all of this project file was on, because on Patreon you can obviously open this project file and go into it. And then there's just the lighting aspect, which I broke down. So pretty simple. The big things I notice when people make, when like let's say someone tries to create this, like the biggest mistakes I'll notice is one, people don't really start in black when they're lighting, so you'll see like white fillers going on around here. The materials and stuff, they don't really put those that well together in terms of like trying to make it look more realistic and real world. And then obviously just the way they go about lighting their products and stuff, there's a lot of rules and principles that they kind of don't really hit on the head. But hopefully you'll learn enough from this tutorial to fix a lot of the issues that you have already. But yeah, when it comes to doing still images, a lot of this is quite basic. When it comes to creating commercials and there's animation and all sorts of other stuff involved, obviously that can get a lot more complicated and there's a lot more going into that. But when it comes to doing still images, you can see how a lot of this is pretty much the same principles that are used in all most of the other tutorials that I've done. So that's the that's all done in 3D. I try and get it as close to the final thing as possible in 3D. So that you're not doing as much in post. So when it came to post, all that was really involved is just some color correction. So when I say color correction here, you can see it's pretty close to the final image. But what I didn't like here was the just the colors. So here was the final render. I wasn't too happy with a blue background. I wanted something that was more neutral instead of blue. So I exported some masks of the product, and then here I just applied some basic color correction. So this is actually not doing anything. But here is just a hue and saturation, just dropping some saturation, dropping some dark, some of the brightness of the background, and then you get that. And here I just went and added a little streak here for the product to add some shine here, because out of the base render you can't really see that, and this part was just easier to add in Photoshop. And then on top of that, you can go and add on like extra text and stuff like that if you want. So this is what the final image looked like in the end. So here you can see everything that I went to in terms of the lighting of the product, some of the post-production. And I just went and spent more time color grading it to what I liked, and that's what you end up with. And then this text was just added into Photoshop. So yeah, that's it for the tutorial. Again, if you want to really go in depth into all the little pieces of this product, you can get it on Patreon. If you really want to take your 3D to the next level and learn how to actually commercialize, how to do the animation, the commercial production, and really create professional work, you can click the link below. I've got a free training which will show you how to master your 3D and so that you can monetize it in 2021. I know so many people have been stuck in the same position for years and years, and for the people that actually want to take the helm and actually start to make a change with their 3D and actually start to master it this year, click the link below. I'm looking forward to another epic year of 2021. Super excited, and I'll see you on the next video.